My name is Dr. Takayile Bizoza. I'm a psychiatrist at Neuropsychiatric Hospital of Ndera here and a psychotherapist. Schizophrenia is a mental disorder. It's a mental disorder which is chronic. It's a chronic mental disorder which is characterized by a divided mind. Schizo means divided, and phrenia means mind or spirit from the Greek word. And this mental disorder is chronic, and the evolution of this mental disorder is made by crisis, dominated by agitation. And also this chronic mental disorder is one of the most severe mental disorder in psychiatry. We have a lot of pathology in psychiatry, but schizophrenia is one of the most severe one. And this mental disorder is transmitted through hereditary way and with family antecedent. And it's affecting commonly young people. This mental disorder have various types and have to be treated most of the time, the whole life of the individual, most of the time. And the types of this mental disorder, this chronic mental disorder, which are very common here, are paranoid schizophrenia, epiphrenia, and schizoaffective disorder. There are symptoms which are more common in all schizophrenic patients that we call the syndrome of dissociation. The syndrome of dissociation is characterized firstly by ambivalence, which is the traduction of this divided mind. You know that our feelings are determined by our thoughts, and our thoughts combined to our feelings determined our daily behaviors. And because of the divided mind that schizophrenics present, then they can develop ambivalence of behaviors and ambivalence of feelings, which means someone can come who is schizophrenic, can come to greet you with a hug, and at the last minute, he'll clap you, he'll beat you. It seems like he is divided with between two feelings, two emotions at the same time: the feeling of love and the feeling of hatred. And this is ambivalence behaviors, which is a consequence of ambivalence of feelings and thoughts. Ambivalence behavior can be also expressed through catatonic position. At the same time, the patient who is schizophrenic can receive from his mind, from his brain, the instruction to stand up. And at the same time, he will receive another opposite instruction that is telling him to sit down. And at the end of this process of act of behavior, he will be between the sitting position and the standing position that he will keep in a fixed position called catatonic position. Yeah, he can, for instance, in the garden, stay in the garden facing the sun during the whole day, or with a position of saluting someone, as it is for those who are corporal in army to salute someone who is captain. He will use the same position to salute someone that you are not seeing, and he will keep the position from the morning to the evening. This is a catatonic position. Catatonic position can be found also when he is going to sleep. The instruction from the mind, from the brain, because the brain is the one rules determine all our thoughts and our feelings and our emotions and behaviors. The instruction from the mind is telling him to sleep. And at the same time, there is another instruction coming from the mind telling him to keep sitting on the bed. And at the end of the process of willing to sleep, he will be behind the two positions. And it seems like there is a pillar behind the head. We call it psychological pillar. It's also a catatonic position. Those are specific to schizophrenia in the domain of mental disorders. And the second group of symptoms which are observed in this syndrome of dissociation, which can be called or considered as the print finger of schizophrenia because they are very specific to schizophrenia, is bizarreria behaviors. They can develop bizarreria behaviors like tendency to the develop consumption of herbs, herbophagia, consumption of what we call in Kinyarwanda, Inyanda, but this consumption is called coprophagia, and he can remove clothes and develop wandering away. Those are bizarreria behaviors, the second group of symptoms in schizophrenia. In schizophrenia, we will have also negative symptoms. Negative symptoms like neglecting of hygiene for many times, for a long time, the one who is developing schizophrenia will not take a good hygiene, and he will develop tendency to wear clothes which are very dirty, and he will come at the hospital with a lot of clothes which are dirty, and with releasing a smell which is very bad, and this is another element that we can find in the group of negative symptoms. Among negative symptoms, we can have also what we call clinophilia, the tendency to stay on the bed, and you will see someone who was very hard-working person, but all the time he's sleeping. You can think that he's develop laziness or is depressed, because in depression we can have this symptom also, but is one of the symptoms of schizophrenia, negative symptoms, staying on the bed, clinophilia. Sometimes it can develop also claustration, tendency to close the door and to keep in the room alone, sometimes with some catatonic position. And other people will think that if he was a religious person, people will think that he is in a moment of prayer or fasting when he's developing a mental disorder, because he can pass a long time without taking food, without taking drinks, and he can develop even dehydration, he can develop malnutrition, and sometimes he can die. That's why it's good when those negative symptoms are found. It's good, very, very important to be treated early. Another group of symptoms that the patient who is schizophrenic can develop is among negative symptoms is the tendency to isolation, the tendency to be alone, not talking about others. Someone who was socializing easily with others, but abruptly, he will keep staying at home, avoiding meeting the old friends, avoiding go to church when he was very prayerful, doctor or son, and avoiding to go to school when he was very brilliant in school. But abruptly, he will stop everything and develop tendency to stay alone, tendency to isolation, and also tendency to avoid activities and to avoid to go to school. Sometimes he can develop failure in schools when he was brilliant, and developed tenants to ask for medical certificate of rape at home, and avoid to go to job when he was very a hard worker person. Those are negative symptoms. Those negative symptoms are commonly found in a group of schizophrenia called ebephrenia. Ebephrenia and ebephreno-catatonic schizophrenia. And another group of symptoms that you can find in schizophrenia, which is commonly observed in the group of paranoid schizophrenia, is the productive symptoms. Productive symptoms or positive symptoms are hallucinations, visual hallucinations, auditory hallucinations, in which the person listens to voices of people that other people are not listening to. And he can see animals, can see people that other people are not seeing. Those are visual hallucinations. They are more frequent, but sometimes they can develop even olfactive hallucinations, like smelling bad smell or good smell, which are not there. And they can develop bad tasting, gustatory hallucinations. And sometimes they can develop even tactile hallucinations, hallucinations in which he will feel like someone is making sex with someone who is not there. This is hallucination of coit, and is among tactile hallucinations, and classified among productive symptoms and positive symptoms, and among delusion conviction. Delusion conviction also are productive symptoms that can be found in schizophrenia. The most common symptoms among delusion conviction are persecution. They are convinced that they are someone, they are victim of witchcraft, they are victim of demons, they are possessed by demons. There are people who want to kill them, and they will develop tendency to wandering away, to flee from there, and this is a delusion of persecution, which is common. Delusion of persecution, delusion of being possessed, and delusion of being guided. Sometimes they can think that someone is broadcasting them. Someone can even read their thoughts. Sometimes other people can listen even to their thoughts, and sometimes give comments to all their daily behaviors, their daily thoughts. Those are comments of thoughts and comments of behaviors. And also they can develop tendency to be convicted that they can transmit thought to others. We call it telepathic thoughts and echo of thoughts. All those are symptoms that can be found in schizophrenia, and they are classified in productive symptoms. But all those symptoms sometimes of schizophrenia can be combined to other group of symptoms which are often found in bipolar disorder, in which we have period of depression with strong sadness, despair, negative vision of life, tendency to indecision, lack of willingness, and with sometimes suicidal thoughts and suicidal attempts. And after this period of depression come another period of manic episode, in which the patient can present excessive joy, with being very talkative, very very inspired, and he can dance without music. He can be very friendly, and develop delusion of grandiosity, conviction that he is very rich, he is very intelligent, he is a very powerful, a great man, and will do great achievement. He will develop tendency to do a lot of projects at the same time. And insomnia, he will not sleep in the night, and the following day he will continue to work without being tired. Excessive energy, excessive generosity, will have tendency to distribute all his good or to enjoy life because it's a pathology of enjoyment. This is the second phase, the second pole, called manic phase in bipolar disorder. We can have those two poles combined with the previous symptoms that I was developing, which are more specific of schizophrenia. When we have this combination of schizophrenic symptoms and bipolar symptoms, we call it schizoaffective disorder. Yeah, this is an overview of the most common symptoms that we found in schizophrenia cases here. And most of the time people are hospitalized because of episode of agitation. They come because of the fact that they create a kind of disorder in the family, in the society. They are agitated, they are becoming aggressive somehow. They are developing dysphoric mood and tendency to destroy goods, and family or police are obliged to bring them to be treated. Most of the time the reason of hospitalization can be is agitation and aggressiveness. Yeah, auto-aggressiveness and also hetero-aggressiveness. Suicidal attempts sometimes can be found in schizophrenia, not only in depression. That's why the evaluation of the suicidal risk is important also in schizophrenia. Those are main symptoms that are found in those various types of schizophrenia. But in DSM-4 and DSM-5 classification, we have some criteria that we have to look for, like the fact that all those symptoms have to be not connected to the consumption of cannabis, amphetamines, or alcohol and other drugs. Otherwise, when it's provoked by those drugs, it's classified in another group of mental disorder called drug-induced psychotic disorder. And another criteria which have to be found out is the fact that all those symptoms have to provoke social dysfunction, professional dysfunction, academic dysfunction, schooling dysfunction, and also family dysfunction to be considered as schizophrenia, because schizophrenia is often accompanied by those dysfunction. But if we treat it early, the patient, sometimes those dysfunction are not observed in a high level. And another element that is considered in American classification called DSM-4 and DSM-5 classification is the fact that all those symptoms mentioned above are not provoked by a medical condition. Because like manic symptoms, they can be provoked by hyperthyroidia and goitrous. And depression can be provoked by hypothyroidia. And manic can be provoked by hypercorticism. And depression can be provoked by the illness of Addison. And can be provoked also by HIV/AIDS. We have to exclude those medical conditions that can be factors of some negative symptoms and even sometimes some psychotic symptoms, because some psychotic symptoms can be connected to tumor of the brain and other neurologic condition. We have to do some exam to exclude those medical illnesses which are provoking those symptoms, and to be sure that it's a pure schizophrenia disorder that we are facing. Yeah, and what I can add is the fact that all those psychotic disorder classified in schizophrenia are accompanied by abnormal disturbances in neuromediators of the brain. Yeah, I have to insist on the fact that schizophrenia is created, is provoked by some disturbances of neuromediator in the brain, like dopamine, which is in excessive level at the intersynaptic neurons level. And this excessive quantity of dopamine lead us to use medication called neuroleptics or antipsychotics. We use them to reduce this level of dopamine in the brain. And we have two type of neuroleptics that we use. We have classical one, first generation antipsychotics, and we have also a second generation antipsychotic. A first generation antipsychotic like Aldol is correcting hallucinations, and Largactil is used to create sedation, is anti-dopaminergic medication. But nowadays we have also second generation antipsychotic like risperidone, which is at the same time anti-dopaminergic and anti-serotoninergic, which can work on those negative symptoms and work on agitation, on hallucinations, on delusion conviction, without the side effects of the previous medication of first generation medication like Largactil and Aldol, which are accompanied by tremors, hypercialorrhea, and trembling, slowness of movement. But with medication, second generation medication like olanzapine, risperidone, Abilify, and other second generation medication, clozapine, quetiapine, they are more interesting because they create few side effects. They give a good comfort of life to patients, and they reduce stigma because you cannot see those side effects on the patients. They reduce stigma, and indirectly they increase the compliance to the treatment, the tendency to compliant to the treatment and to be stable for a long time. And we are doing in the country and also in our hospital a research in which after the research, it will be facilitated to have the medication of those antipsychotic like risperidone, paliperidone, palmitate, on injectable level, and it can be administered just once every 3 months and every 6 months. You will see some patients coming here in the hospital just two times, and this will reduce the overcrowd that we have in OPD, because we have a lot of patients who are coming because of relapses and also because of the lack of those medication that we can give for a long term to stabilize our patients. Another thing that I can say is the fact that we don't use only medication. We use biopsychosocial approach. We use psychotherapy to deal with psychological problems, family problems, couples problems, and individual problems that can lead to relapses in schizophrenia. And between crisis and during the hospitalization, we use this approach of psychotherapy. And we use also social approach to facilitate the reintegration of the patient in the community after the treatment, after the hospitalization. Yeah, and this biopsychosocial approach is used to give a good stabilization of our patients. And we do also psychoeducation, in which we insist on the fact that those mental disorders are not connected by to demonic possession, are not connected to family curses, are not connected to witchcraft, but they are connected to some disturbances of neuromediator in the brain, And when those disturbances are corrected by the medication that you are giving, people can get a normal life and they can be successful in their studies. We have a lot of students who are successful in university, who are successful in marriage, who are successful in their job, who are professor, and they are schizophrenic, but they are professor in university, they are students, they are good wife, good husband. That's why it's very important to fight self-stigma. Don't say that you have developed one crisis, two crises of mental disorder. You cannot be married, you cannot develop entrepreneurship, you cannot work. No, you can make a good life if you are treated at a good time and early. Avoid to go for prayer first. You can go, they pray for you, but they bring you quickly to be treated. And avoid to go to traditional healers, and prefer going to receive medication, because nowadays mental health is decentralized, and those medications are availed in district hospitals and even sometimes in health centers, and they can benefit of this good. Politics of mental health decentralization, our population can benefit of it and go early to be treated instead of going to camp of prayer and to traditional healers. And after being treated, they can continue to receive prayers. It's good, prayer help also, but they have to be treated early and continue to take their medication. Avoid those false prophecies saying to them, you are cured now, stop your medication. And when they stop the medication, they relapse again. They come back and their mental disorder is becoming chronic. This is the advice that I can give to our population. That's good to pray, but it's good also to be treated early and continue to pray and being treated, working together with medical doctors, social workers, psychologists. It will be very helpful for them to be in good life and contribute in the development of our country.